Hold on a second. Who is this mysterious character we have here? This number number 76, or I guess 71 technically, but Joker coming out of front being played by Adi. Now, I didn't even know Adi Ray's playing Joker?
Yeah, Utopian Ray. We have seen his Joker earlier on in the bracket. In fact, he was sent into loser's bracket by Mr. E after taking game number one with Palutena and then two and three with Joker. Utopian Ray abandoning. He does not want the Palutena Ditto. He's going to face off with the Palutena, with the King of Phantom Thieves. However, Odyssey stealing stock number one.
You know, I just assumed that Adi would be the one playing playing Joker, because like Joker is not like a Utopian Ray character. That's like, caught me completely off guard to see him rocking this character. But we'll see how it works out so far. I mean, he's getting pretty outfootsied so far from Adi. But the thing is, he's got the Arsene charge, and this Arsene charge is going to increase a lot of his knockbacks on a ton of moves. Adds that spike to downer, allows him to be able to go for some spikes offstage. Now, here we go. He had the very long range. I don't know why he went for the bullet special offstage. I guess just trying to clip Adi, but it's not going to lead into a kill or anything.
I mean, Palutena is not easy to gimp, so I can't imagine bullet being the most optimal option here. However, it's Joker. It's still a relatively new character, only a week old. Odyssey somehow missing on the recovery. He was definitely going for something. Was that Utopian Ray chasing him away, or what do you think, Austin?
On the SD?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. That was just basically Adi just flubbed up. He tried to grab onto the ledge. He misinputted it, so he just kind of fell to his death. I mean, there was the Ahas kind of forcing out the warp a little bit earlier than normal, but yeah, I think he just flubbed. But that's okay, because you know he's coming back into the second stock. He still has a very significant lead, 50% deficit right now between the two. And you know, Ray's doing a good job just trying to stay away from Adi while trying to like find his openings, right? Because Joker doesn't have that big of range. Like, even though it's technically a sword character, that is still a dagger when you think about it.
Yeah, I mean, it's crazy how Wolf is still more of a swordy than Joker is.
Oh, yeah. I mean, Joker, I mean, Wolf is a swordy, man. Let's be real.
Oh, yeah.
Cross him up with the grab, tossing him up. This could be a potential back air action. And that forward tilt will actually lead into a kill. So you see Adi trying to go for that block, even though he's right behind him. Dash attack to open him up. This could be an opportunity to land a back air or a nair. Dare wants to go for a nair instead, but because he re-grabbed onto that ledge, that's going to be a free down smash coming out from Adi.
Now, and if this is a silly question, definitely call me out on it. But Utopian Ray, he made his it on the PR with the Palutena. So what can he transfer from his play as Palutena over to a new character in Joker? Like, what's transferable?
Honestly, there's just neutral skill, in my honest opinion. But right now, I feel like nothing's transferring over for Ray. I feel like this is looking like Ray is just trying to discover how to play this character. Literally, Devin just said counters are the same. Whatever,
with
man.
With Arsene, yeah.
They both have the same counter because they both have the ability to counter and reflect, but I don't think that's going to be that big of a deal. But he's just messing with me. That's fine. But
Devin, if that were any more of a reach, your shoulder would have hyperextended. I'm just saying. Anyway.
I agree, man. Okay, back throw. Not enough to get that kill. You see him sitting at high percent. At this point, just catches the down air. Going to be able to two-frame him on that ledge, just throwing an active hitbox. And now Ray starting to bring it back little by little.
Yeah, step by step. That's usually how you do it. There are multiple steps in pulling off a robbery, and certainly in taking stocks off of Palutena. However, I mean, you're sitting at 10%, getting these hits on Palutena. Easier said than done. You really are kind of relying on Odyssey to drop the defenses, and with a defensively based character, which I mean, we see Palutena so high up on the tier list. It's so weird to think of her in that light, but that's still what she is at her core. That's what her toolkit kind of dictates about her play. And Odyssey, keeping that in mind, only sitting at 37% right now.
Yeah, doing a fantastic job surviving. Just runs in there, gets the grab, tries to toss him into the blast, but now Arsene has arrived. Even though there is technically invincibility on that up B, it's only active for 23 frames right in the beginning of it. So it's not as safe as like they claim to be in that little direct, right? Because they're making a big deal about how it's invincible, but it's only on the startup, man. You saw how close he was to the ledge. We saw that down tilt coming out from Adi, managed to just scoop him up, land him into a free forward air. And honestly, that would have been an opportunity where I felt like Arsene messed up Ray a bit. I felt like if you just would have gone for the grappling hook, if you didn't have Arsene, would have made it back to the stage safe and sound. So that was just a a little worrisome for him.
Indeed. So those Wings of Rebellion getting clipped by the two-frame down tilt into the aerial. And just like that, Palutena chases him off of Joker, and out comes the Olimar of Utopian Ray. So Palutena versus Olimar, I'm as excited as you are, folks. So Pokemon Stadium 2, for Game 2. So switching to Olimar, do you like this pick, Aussie?
I honestly, Utopian Ray's played Olimar in the past. He played him a lot in the Smash 4 days.
This is true.
And he still messes around with him in this game as well, honestly. But what I really want to see is his Palutena. I'm not sure why he's not going Palutena. Maybe he just doesn't want to do the mirror match, the Ditto against Oddie. But we'll see what happens. I like it a lot more than his week one Joker.
True. And now, and obviously with the prominence of Olimar in the game, especially at Pound, where we had two of them in top eight, the Buzz and the eventual grand finalist, and Myron looking for the footstool, not finding it. Utopian Ray able to get back some cheeky stuff from Odyssey. But he says, okay, you think you're so cute, have a purple Pikmin to the face. That's going to take stock number one off of Odyssey.
Yeah.
Olimar, very prominent, and yeah, you can kind of see why.
Exactly, man. You know, that blue Pikmin's really good at being able to catch those grabs, increases that knockback and damage whenever you connect it. And Ray has a really good control over, like, his lineup of which Pikmin he's going to be using against in whatever, like, situation, right? Because right now he's got a purple, one of the most famous Pikmin in the roster. You know what? We like to call her Monique because mm-hmm. she's got hips that don't lie.
This is true. You mean the Shakira?
Oh, yeah. So, no, okay. we call her Monique.
Man. Okay, fair enough.
Yeah.
I mean, hey, New York, you do you. I'm cool with it.
And now we got Oddie coming back out, trying to drag him down with that neutral air. A lot of Palutenas like to go for that option, but just go and runs right off the platform, going for a very famous back air off the platform. A lot of characters like to do that. And that's a really early kill for Oddie.
Now Utopian Ray with the slight advantage, but for how long? It's Odyssey not finding it as easy to connect and get those signature nairs that Palutena is so known for. Olimar, one of the few characters it seems like can slow down Palutena when she wants to approach. Utopian Ray is having a devil of a time.
Yeah, I mean
with Odyssey, of course, but still maintaining the lead. Yeah.
Yeah, you see him just chilling off stage here. You just easily, you saw Oddie go in for a dash attack, extremely unsafe on shield, and Ray just had the blue Pikmin at the ready, got the grab, got the kill. That's the second time we've seen Oddie die to a grab.
And now Odyssey is a full stock lead for Utopian Ray. Odyssey, I mean, we saw Utopian Ray. Obviously, he's an incredibly capable player. You don't just make it as one of the top players in New York by being a slouch. You don't get that way anywhere in Tri-State. But nonetheless, having a having to go with Olimar in order to deal with the very in-form Palutena of Odyssey, who wound up finishing third at Spectrum Smash, which is almost becoming like a mini Xeno in terms of the quality that comes out. But Kazza with the purple Pikmin. Odyssey not able to evade.
Okay, again, he's going to be able to catch that back air, you know, just going for that simple ledge jump, gets up there, sees him trying to recover with that winged Pikmin, he's going to be able to throw that out, bash him in with that shield, and now Oddie, honestly, one stock away from moving on into loser's semis, which would be a really good showing for him, because, right, Oddie's like the same thing as Mystery, right? He had a little bit of a hard time bringing this, you know, back to his, like, skill level that he had in Smash 4, had a very slow start trying to figure out which character he wants to play with. But he's bringing it back little by little. I'm pretty sure he made it onto the PR. But
oh
hey,
my.
There's going to be a forward smash coming out strong, dude.
Indeed, and Utopian Ray is going to send this to a game number three and trying to render the two-game win streak of Odyssey and Loser's Bracket null and void. Odyssey making it here by beating Mr. Mojo Ryzen and indeed Deadly Alliance's Venya by a score of 2-1 in Loser's Round 4. So as Utopian Ray, wait a second, we're seeing a new tag being made. Is... Well, what are you expecting from Utopian Ray right here?
Is this Utopian Ray? Oh, what's up, Bars?
Oh,
what's going on, dude? Hey, is there like a moderator in the chat right now? Could you just like time him out real quick? Can someone do that for me? Okay. If there's a moderator in the chat, just time out Bars real quick. I really appreciate that.
You're a good man, Aussie.
I am, dude. I try to look out for my friends.
Yeah,
but
fair
enough. So one thing that I'm completely shocked out about, by the way, is that Oddie beat Venya. That's Vinny got 7th place today. That's a little uncharacteristic of him. I don't think he's really – he doesn't really plays that low at Xenos lately. So either maybe he just had a bad day or everyone else is leveling up hardcore. Everyone else is having a good day. But regardless, going to jump into this game three, see who's going to be going down with the fifth place finish and who's going to be fighting off against the winner of Ray and Adi. Dill and Zamba.
Not trying to present this as an excuse as much as a reason, but this is the first tournament, I believe, with patch 3.0. So
yes.
Perhaps just struggling to adjust to the meta, and it happens to the best of us. Venya, he's allowed an off week, and indeed was going through it and loses bracket, taking out John Numbers 2-0, but again eventually losing to Odyssey. So as Odyssey tries to maintain stage control in this game number three, the adjustments being made, what do you see Odyssey doing differently against this Olimar in game three?
Honestly, not seeing too much different, if I'm being real here. He's just trying to, like, play it safe, playing neutral. I mean, the Smashville stage is helping him out a lot here because, he's chilling underneath that platform, doing a fantastic job of getting these edge guards. Again, just jumping right above him, going for the empty hop, gets the grab, back throw. It's a pretty strong option to go for. And again, I like that mix-up. You saw him land right in front of him to try to bait out a reaction from Ray. Did a little quick dash chance to get the re-grab. He's very hungry for this back throw. If you're going to chill underneath there, dog, with a wing Pikmin, you're going to get stage spike. It's going to happen.
Yeah, absolutely, especially with that shield. Whatever is in that shield of Palutena's, it is like she must load that thing with buckshot for that back air to be so powerful. But nonetheless, taking the first stock of game number three is Odyssey. So he finds himself up 3-2. And what I'm noticing, I guess with Palutena versus Olimar, obviously it worked out for Utopian Ray in game number two. He had to take his chances and they all worked out. But I feel like, oh my goodness, Odyssey.
If you're going to double jump like that, dog, he's going to come in with that down air. But Ray responding in kind, going for a forward smash, getting rid of that stock. And we're going to see what's going to happen here because Odyssey got a stock lead, which is a... very good for him, right? Because he just needs to take one more stock, move on into loser semi. It's a really, really strong start for him.
But he was giving... what a lock.
Jab
gracious.
Lockies.
Odyssey finding himself in a position to have a comeback made on him. However, Utopian Ray, he still has a few more steps to take the throw. And I feel like just what's working out for Odyssey in this game number three, just in the first half of the game, The nature of the character allows him to play a more risk-averse game. He just has more things that he can do that are safe. And obviously, Olimar, it's not really the character that you usually pick, especially in Smash 4 when you were not prone to take chances. Obviously, he has some things that are a lot safer, a lot of things that make him more effective. I mean, that fire, that red Pikmin, obviously, proving my point there. And just like that, we're at a one-stock game, so Odyssey needs to make the adjustment and fast. Back throw is a good way to start.
I like that option from Ray. Honestly, if he puts out the explosive flame, he's out of resources really bad. He had to fade away to avoid that second explosive flame. Manages to go for that wing Pikmin as fast as possible, throwing away his entire Pikmin. Now, at this point, you notice that Adi was trying to get in his face and try to attack him while he was Pikminless, which is why you saw Utopian Ray throwing up some hands, going for the jab, which you don't see very often from this character.
The purple Pikmin giving him just enough knockback. Utopian Ray is making this interesting. Odyssey. Not exactly back against the wall here, however, being made to sweat by Utopian Ray. The yellow Pikmin gets pulled out.
Things are starting to turn slowly for him, man. He's offstage at 134%. Again, respecting that explosive flame before he gets back on stage. Gonna have to air dodge to avoid that grab. This is looking really tense. He's got a blue as well. He's gonna be able to mix up if he's gonna go for a grab or a forward smash.
Avoiding a series of grabs at that, just not able to catch the landings of Utopian Ray. And all of a sudden, Ray
there
is in
was.
His head.
Why did he hold that?
Top throw, Utopian Ray says you will die where you stand. And just like that, he moves on by a score of 2-1, a reverse three-stock Austie.
Honestly, Adi was playing fearful that entire last, 10 seconds because there was a moment when he was on the edge of the stage holding shield, and you saw the opponent, Utopian Ray, he had a blue Pikmin, clearly had him, so it showed Adi wasn't looking at the lineup. If you have a blue Pikmin, guess what he's going to do?
Yeah.
He's going to grab. He's going to grab you, and that's exactly what he was doing. He was holding shield, got the grab, got the kill with the percent, and that's what happens, man. Ray got...